The keto diet has been becoming increasingly popular over the past few years. And personally, I do use it with some of my clients who require rapid weight loss. But is ketosis safe during pregnancy? Well, today I'm going to provide you with an update on the research about low carbohydrate diets in pregnancy. Stay tuned. Rather than focusing on practical tips like we do on many episodes of Nourish, today I want to dig into the research. But first, I want to give you a quick overview of what ketosis actually is. Just like a phone, animal, or plant, our bodies need fuel to function. We get that fuel from food, actually, more specifically, usually from the carbohydrates in food. But I'm sure that you've heard that as long as we still have water, we can survive for a few weeks without food. When this happens, our body uses our fat stores for fuel in a process called ketosis. Now, ketosis literally means making energy from fat stores and is a popular way to lose weight. Now, current stats tell us that approximately half of all pregnant women are overweight when they conceive. And this additional weight can lead to a range of pregnancy complications. So it stands to reason that you might be wondering whether a keto diet might be a healthy choice during pregnancy, especially if you've been diagnosed with gestational diabetes. However, the current evidence suggests that ketosis is generally not safe during pregnancy. Let me explain. First of all, pregnancy is a time when our nutritional requirements soar. And when we cut out carbohydrate-containing foods such as fruit, dairy products, starchy vegetables, legumes like chickpeas and lentils, and whole grains, it can be more challenging to meet your pregnancy nutrition requirements. Secondly, our fluid requirements skyrocket during pregnancy. But when our body is in ketosis, we lose fluid faster. You see, our liver and our muscles store carbohydrates to provide our body with fuel during short-term fasts, like overnight, for example. And each gram of carbohydrate stores, which are actually called glycogen, they hang on to about 3 grams of fluid. So if our body has used up all of these carbohydrate stores, it's more difficult for our body to retain fluid, which is why you need to pee so much when you're on a low-carb diet. Now, low fluid stores can increase your risk of pregnancy complications like constipation and urinary tract infections, which, as you know, are already a big problem during pregnancy. Thirdly, although you might be tempted to go on a low-carb diet if you develop gestational diabetes, a study of lower carbohydrate diets in women with gestational diabetes found that it didn't improve the number of women who needed to commence insulin injections. So it doesn't seem to be much benefit there either. And number four, and probably most importantly, is that the ketone bodies, which are produced when our body is in ketosis, they cross our placenta. As our babies require a constant source of carbohydrates for growth and development, there are concerns about how these ketone bodies and the lack of carbohydrates may impact the growth and development of your baby. However, it's important to note that a ketogenic diet can be one of the best treatments for some women with epilepsy, so it is important that more research is done into this area. Now, in 2017, there was research undertaken on 2 pregnant women with epilepsy as they followed a ketogenic diet throughout their pregnancies. The first woman didn't follow a true keto diet, but had a reduced carbohydrate diet, including about 75 grams of carbohydrate per day from 14 weeks gestation. Now, she experienced a range of nutritional deficiencies, but had a healthy baby. So that's great news. The second mum was on a keto diet prior to conceiving and stayed on this diet right throughout her pregnancy. She did deliver a healthy baby, but unfortunately the baby was born with some physical deformities. Now, I should also mention that there have been some animal studies conducted, and these have also found mixed results. Some of the side effects of ketosis during pregnancy in these studies have included problems with brain development, physical deformities, nutritional deficiencies, and behavioural issues in the offspring. Furthermore, preliminary research seems to suggest that ketosis is not recommended in the weeks leading up to conception either. Now, to summarise, I think that we need to remember that there's not much research on whether or not ketosis is safe during pregnancy, and until more evidence comes out on to how to manage it safely, it's wise to cease your keto diet prior to conceiving, or as soon as you know that you're pregnant, if at all possible. If you do have epilepsy and really need to stay on a keto diet, then just make sure that you see a dietitian with expertise in this area. Now, if you would like help with a healthy diet during pregnancy, I'd love you to download my free pregnancy meal plan. Just go to www.melaniemcgrice.com/pregnancy and make sure that you subscribe so that you receive all of my weekly videos. I look forward to seeing you again next week. Oh, this fringe.